Hey everyone, I'm Jason Dean.
And I'm Colby Dane.
And this is Real Physics, where we tell you what would really happen in Hollywood production.
Because our disbelief can only be suspended so far.
Hey everybody, while we haven't yet covered the original XXX with Vin Diesel, which has loads of content.
Actually, it's a historically accurate documentary.
I did not know that. We did catch this scene from the sequel with Ice Cube that is just begging to be covered.
How about a car sparking down some train rails from XXX State of the Union?
Let's take a look. Okay, so we've got Ice Cube playing Darius Stone, who is some kind of former U.S. Navy SEAL. Here we see him doing his best impression of a secret agent, chasing down a high-speed train in some sort of sports car, looking like a badass.
And here come the bad guys in the train, doing some bad things, blah, 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 contrived plot, here's the Green Goblin, blah, blah, blah. The bad guys see he's coming for them and decide to go even faster.
Now, Ice sees them pulling away, and he makes a ridiculous decision. He violently turns at 160 miles per hour onto the train tracks.
And now we see Ice Cube in what appears to be a car-shaped couch sitting in front of a large projector screen.
And here's the scene in question.
Tires exploding, sparks flying, and a car landing perfectly on the tracks in high pursuit.
This was obviously the only sensible thing for him to do here.
Now, anyone with any common sense would obviously do that.
Now, whatever just happened there would have likely torn apart even the most robustly prepared car. But this is XXX.
And here we see the speedometer again putting him at 160 miles per hour and coming up on the back of the train.
So now he's coming up on the train, and then he lets go of the wheel to fire into the back so he can break the glass and climb aboard. Oh, but he needs a way for the car to catch on the back of the train, so...
Some explosions and a missed opportunity for an Ozzy Osbourne song, and here we see him climbing on the hood, finally getting aboard, and then an exploding sports car goes flying back for no reason.
Let's see if we can throw this scene off the rails.
What we want to do is determine the hypothetical aerodynamic drag of this impossibly tough sports car.
Then we can compare that with the available friction force at the wheels with no tires and against the train tracks.
Seems straightforward enough, but first some research.
Okay, the car in the movie may not look familiar to you because it's a one-of-a-kind Ford Shelby Cobra concept. It was unveiled at the 2004 North American International Auto Show in Detroit, and it never went into production.
The car features a 6.4-liter V10 capable of creating 645 horsepower. Ford claimed the car could reach a speed of 267 miles per hour or 430 kilometers per hour, but then again, they also claimed to have invented the assembly line, so whatever.
It had no air conditioning, windshield wipers, radio, or even anti-lock brakes. It was actually meant to be the smallest amount of car with the absolute most power.
Yeah, it seems legit for a super agent's car.
Okay, so now we know what kind of car this is.
And lucky for us, a lot of the specs and information for the Cobra are published.
All right, so let's go ahead and get to the math. All right, in the scene, we see the Cobra on the street approaching 160 miles per hour.
And again, based on the specs, this seems legitimate.
First, let's calculate the aerodynamic drag on this beast at this speed.
Without going into all the input variables, we can get the aerodynamic drag of a moving body from this equation.
And solving for that comes out to 556 pounds of drag, which really seems like a lot.
Okay, now let's take a look at the force available from the friction between the aluminum wheels, which strangely are sparking despite being aluminum, and the train rails.
Okay, the coefficient of friction between aluminum and steel is 0.61. So when you take into account the weight of the back half of the Cobra, since it's a rear-wheel drive vehicle, you get 937 pounds of friction force.
Okay, wait a minute, 937 pounds of available friction force pushing the Cobra forward? And remember, at 160 miles an hour, we calculated 556 pounds of aerodynamic drag.
So, after all that, despite the car not even having any tires, it actually looks like he would be able to maintain and even continue to accelerate at 160 miles per hour. In fact, at 160 miles per hour, he's still just in fourth gear.
Nuts.
Even more nuts is that at 170 miles per hour, the estimated aerodynamic drag is still only 628.42 pounds.
And of course, this assumes the 6.4 liter, 645 horsepower V10 can make enough power to push this much air.
Okay, so can it?
Well, the equation for the power required to overcome aerodynamic friction is 1/2 the density of air times V sub Ice cubed times the drag coefficient times the frontal area.
So that results in only using 284 horsepower of its available 645 horsepower. So based on that, how fast could this car theoretically go anyway?
Well, if you take the power equation and solve for velocity and use the 645 horsepower figure as an input, you get 223 miles per hour or 359 kilometers per hour. Wow, that boggles the mind, even though it is less than the claimed 267 miles per hour.
So somehow, if Ice Cube was actually able to get his car onto the tracks, which should have resulted in total catastrophe, and then all four tires magically popped at the same time, according to our math, it looks like he should be able to catch up to the train.
Even with ice on the tracks.
All right, let's call it.
As much as we wanted to derail this scene, this is real physics.
Don't you mean rail physics?
No.
All right, until next time, thanks for watching.
See you next week. XXX, State of the Union.
All right, let's take a look.
State of the Union.
THQ. Bankrupt. I feel bad for them. They made lots of good games.
How do you pronounce that lens name?
Leica?
It's Leica?
Leica.
I was...
Huh. Like how it's written.
I'm gonna kill you.
All right, let's take a look. Choppy, choppy, choppy.
You too.
The band?
No, the spy plane. Wait, you're using Wikipedia as a source for the show? Because you know it's all wrong.
Gasp.
Because what's gonna happen is now Wiki's gonna start quoting us for their...
Oh no!
Okay,
here we go. That's actually funnier. Kind Ford Shelby Cobra concept. It was unveiled at the. It was unveiled at the two. It was unveiled at the
2004.
It was unveiled at the